Is radiation an actual health hazard? When you hear about radiation, scary images of Chernobyl and the dropping of atomic bombs inevitably come to mind. As scary as they were, radiation has forever changed thousands of lives. And did you know that you're constantly surrounded by radiation? X-rays, mobile phones, the soil of the earth, and even sunlight emit radiation. In today's video, let's discuss what radiation does to your body, what the kinds of radiation are, and if there's a way to protect yourself from the hazards. We're talking all that and more. What exactly is radiation? The energy originating from a source and traveling at the speed of light is radiation. It is classified as both harmful and non-harmful. Both these radiation types have different energy levels and can come from man-made or natural sources. Radiation travels in waves. Of course, you can't see these waves, but you can feel them in the form of heat or light. There's another term for harmful radiation, ionizing radiation. This includes X-rays, gamma rays, ultraviolet radiation, and radon gas. When a radioactive particle interacts with the cells in your body, it changes the charge on them and makes them highly unstable. This process ionizes the atoms in your body, thus the term ionizing radiation. The supercharged cells start destroying other healthy cells as they pass through the body. They destroy healthy tissues, RNA, and DNA, which could be particularly dangerous. DNA is the primary molecule that stores information about the proper functioning of every cell. Once they get destroyed, the cell function is forgotten. Your body cells start forgetting how to revive themselves after damage. DNA damage can further cause cancer and even death. But that's not always the case. Non-harmful radiation that contains lesser energy levels cannot cause extensive damage. Harmful radiation can induce something called ARS, short for acute radiation syndrome. The radioactive elements target rapidly multiplying organs like hair, skin, reproductive organs, and bone marrow. So having hair loss, patchy inflamed skin, and poor reproductive functions are telltale signs of higher radiation doses. Your body will lose its ability to fight infection since the bone marrow will not produce enough white blood cells to combat viruses and bacteria. Also, nausea, vomiting, and blood in stool are common signs. Your thyroid gland, a butterfly-shaped organ sitting at the base of your neck, also has an affinity toward radiation. It can absorb much more than other parts of the body. Since the thyroid gland controls different functions via thyroid hormones, affecting their production could be a big blow to your entire system. Lastly, radiation can also target your nervous system and brain. Loss of memory, speech issues, unconsciousness, and seizures usually happen in the later stages. But for all this to happen, your body must undergo tremendous radiation. Scientists measure the amount of radiation in units called sieverts. The actual radiation absorbed by a body is measured in gray. For all safety purposes, exposure of 100 millisieverts per year is considered a safe dose for ordinary people. For professionals having to deal with ionizing radiation exposure, it can be 50 millisieverts. Let's now talk about medical imaging. Computed tomography or CT scans, X-rays, and fluoroscopy all have the potential to damage your DNA, but these imaging modalities are lifesavers. The benefits outweigh the risk when done under mindful supervision. A single chest X-ray emits 0.1 millisieverts of radiation, while a chest CT scan delivers 7 sieverts. A mammogram exposes women to 0.4 millisieverts. In contrast, a PET scan exposes you to 25 millisieverts of radiation. A stomach X-ray causes 8 millisieverts of radiation exposure in adults. Dental X-rays require even less exposure. If you're worried about the radiation from such imaging tests, talk to your healthcare provider. Usually the doctors will use a barrier or a shield to cover other organs that are not being imaged. A lead apron or a thyroid lead collar does the trick. Also, maintain a record of your medical imaging to prevent repeat tests. Moreover, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention talks about other types of radiation in your day-to-day life and how to tackle them. Have you planned a flight? Be prepared to take in some radiation. We're not trying to scare you. Scientists found that traveling from the east to the west in the United States would expose you to 0.035 millisieverts of cosmic radiation. The sun and other stars in space produce this radiation, which is way less than you would receive from one stomach X-ray. Longer duration and higher altitude could cause more radiation exposure. Pregnant females should avoid multiple air journeys. You could also be exposed to radiation before boarding that plane. Although the amount would be meager, airport security screening uses body scanning units that release low radiation levels. Technology that the United States airports use currently has low-energy, non-ionizing radiation. The radiation releases 1,000 times less energy than a mobile phone. The next thing might come as a surprise, but your building could also expose you to a small amount of radiation daily. Natural radioactive substances like radium, uranium, and thorium are present in construction raw materials like sandstone, brick, gypsum, granite, and even concrete. These are the same elements that are used in a nuclear power plant. But the amount of radioactive substances is negligible in construction. Over time, as the materials disintegrate, it causes the elements to decay and emit a radioactive gas called radon. This gas can enter your home through cracks and holes in your home's foundation or private water well. All the levels would be low. It's unlikely to harm your health. If you're still concerned, you can get your building tested to ensure the safety levels of radon gas. The Earth also emits something called terrestrial radiation. You can also find radon gas in rocks, soil, and natural water bodies. It can be breathed in or consumed via water as it's colorless and odorless. In the United States, an average person inhales annual radiation of 2 millisieverts. Inhalation of radon gas accounts for 73% of a person's early exposure to active substances from natural sources. The radiation is comparable to 20 doses of chest x-rays. On the flip side, only 9% of a person's early exposure comes from ingesting radioactive substances. An average person eats and drinks minor doses of radioactive elements. The amount is somewhat comparable to 2 chest x-rays. Did you know that cigarettes also contain radiation? Smoking claims more American lives than alcohol, drugs, accidents, AIDS, suicide, and homicides combined. The commonly known fact about cigarette smoking is that it can cause cancer. But what is lesser known, because of radioactive materials like polonium-210 and lead-210, these toxic cigarette substances can harm smokers or someone inhaling secondhand smoke. Farmers spray tobacco crops with high phosphate fertilizers. The radioactive materials from the fertilizers settle on the tobacco leaves. They remain on the leaves even after processing into cigarettes. This radiation is typically dangerous as you inhale toxic substances in your lungs. Years of smoking build up a sticky, tar-like substance in the lungs' airways. There's no way for the radioactive material to escape. According to a few studies, we can blame smoking for 90% of men's lung cancer deaths and about 80% of women's. Now, let's come to the most common source of radiation that almost everybody carries: your cell phone. Having a phone in your pocket or at your bedside has become common practice for many. Our lives depend on this tiny device in this fast-paced world. But the danger of mobile phones still lurks in everybody's mind. Cell phones do use frequency radiation, or RF, for sending out signals. It's the same radiation used for x-rays, but scientists still struggle to answer whether mobile phones cause cancer. The International Agency for Cancer Research has classified radio frequency radiation as a possible human carcinogen. That means it can cause cancer in humans. While studies are still underway, scientists have found a connection between cell phone usage and a few types of tumor that causes hearing loss. It can also cause headaches, memory issues, insomnia, and vision problems. You can switch to hands-free headsets instead of talking directly on the phone. That way, strong radio frequency radiation can stay away from the brain. You can also use a speakerphone alternatively. If you have a pacemaker installed in your heart, your cell phone can affect it. Make sure to have a word with your healthcare provider. Moving along, do you wear sunscreen when you step out of the house? The sun emits ultraviolet radiation and can affect your skin and cause cancer. The same radiation is responsible for producing vitamin D in your body, but the harmful effects start when you're overexposed. Tanning beds can also cause premature skin aging, sunburns, and cancer. Mercury vapor lamps, halogen, fluorescent, and incandescent lights, and a few lasers emit harmful radiation. Nearly all of the ultraviolet radiation that enters the Earth's surface is UVA. This is because the ozone layer absorbs all the UVC radiation and UVB rays. UVA is more notorious and can penetrate your skin even deeper. It is present all year round and not just on sunny days. Using sunblock helps significantly. Get one with higher SPF. Wear wide sunglasses and hats to cover your face. Cover your arms and legs with long clothes, and do not try indoor tanning if you're a young adult. It increases your chance of developing melanoma. Lastly, do you wear fitness trackers and smartwatches? Wearable computer technology is directly in contact with your body. These tiny devices give off radiation as they receive data over the radio frequency from your smartphones and the internet. This type of radiation is similar to your hands-free headsets or low-power Bluetooth sets. The Federal Communications Commission has set limits on the exposure of such devices. Most manufacturers adhere to these guidelines, so it is less harmful. But radiation is not the only cause of cancer. Shockingly, your diet also plays a vital role in putting you at risk for certain cancers. Don't believe it? Then check out these top 5 cancer-causing foods you should avoid, or 12 cancer-causing foods that you should not eat. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both and learn what to eat and drink to prevent cancer. Have you ever given serious thought to radiation exposure? Let us know in the comments below.